for 2022, what specifically has the Lord shown you? I know earlier you were sharing about a dream you had.
Yeah, on January 1st, I'd had a real interesting dream. I walked into a poker hall. Just throwing this out there, I don't gamble or play poker. But I walked into a poker hall, and on the top, it said 2020 times two.
Oh, God.
And so I immediately got this feeling that maybe 2022 would try to mimic 2020. At the table, there was a political figure, and then there was five mega church pastors that were around the table. And the first hand went through, and I noticed that at the table, there was one seat that was open. When the second hand went through, that political figure had what's known as pocket rockets or two aces. And he pushed all of his chips into the table, and every single megachurch pastor folded one by one. Immediately, a man walked in with a t-shirt on. His t-shirt said Remnant, and he walked to the table, and he played his hand, and I noticed it was a full house. Mm. And I noticed that the political figure was not expecting that this Remnant person was going to come in and beat him with a full house. And so
I didn't even know that. So a full house would beat.
Wait, I want to talk about this because I understand poker. Okay, so for everyone who's watching, if you don't understand poker, two double aces, that's like one of the best things you can have.
Yes.
But one of the few things that can trump that is a full house. And the likeliness of you getting that is very unlikely. Yeah,
very unlikely. I think there could be multiple interpretations to the dream, but what God specifically told me was the double aces was the 2020 and the 2022. The remnant in the full house, the Lord said to me in the dream, 2022 will feel like 2020 early on. And I think we've seen that with some of the virus, but the Lord said to me, but I'm looking for a remnant who's going to gather in the full house and call the bluff. I really have been encouraging people, you know, don't fear, don't get paranoid. 2022 is not going to be as deadly as it was in 2020. But the Lord, really, it's the full house. We need people to gather, whether it's in their homes, in the church buildings. We need a remnant to arise.
We need a full house of the remnant to stand up.
And to call the bluff.
Wait, I have a question. Why do you think the mega churches are folding?
Well, I think that there's an agenda there. I'm not saying all, but I think that there's a political agenda sort of being in agreement with an agenda from the government. And I do think that there's a spirit of fear. I do think that a lot of larger churches are being controlled by the government and they're cowering, not meeting.
Or they've believed the narrative.
Yeah.
Well, for many of the things that are going on in the world today, they have just accepted it blindly, not knowing that it was deception from the enemy from the beginning, and it was going to be about control, not even the pandemic, but it was much deeper than that, wasn't
it? And that was a good question, Rachel, because if you're in a game, the political figure had the two aces, that's an intimidating hand. And these churches have been intimidated, so it's almost like they're all like, well, let's just fold, let's give up, let's fold. But what's cool is that you said we have to gather as a full house and call the bluff.
Yeah.
And when someone's bluffing in poker, they don't have as good of a hand as they're saying they do. Yeah.
They're pretending.
And so the enemy is trying to intimidate us right now.
Yeah. And that's what Jonathan Kahn said when he was here. Mm-hmm. Similar. Do you remember he said that 2022 would look a lot like 2020? Mm-hmm. He said, but as the darkness is coming, the light is going to be greater to overshadow the darkness. Yes. But we have to be that full house, and we have to stand up. It's like
call the enemy's bluff. Well,